For Best Music Coach, my name is Dan, and you are watching A Music Teacher's Reaction Live and in Real Time. Two, well, I'm going to say this wrong. Terraria. Oh my goodness. Calamity Mod. Anyway, we're going to get right into it. I've never heard this before, not once ever, never, ever, ever. So all my reactions, all my comments, all the teaching that I'm going to do as we go is going to be right off the top of my head in the moment. Now, this is going to be a little bit of a very interactive stream. Hey, chat, how's it going? Chat is going to help me out and let me know because these songs in this OST apparently loop around. And so they're going to give me a shout out. Yeah, I'm so sorry about my pronunciation there, chat. We'll get it. Terraria. All right, we got it. Cool. Let's get this thing rocking and rolling with The Tale of a Cruel World. Ooh. Terraria. Huh. Terraria. Terraria. Thank you, chat, for letting me know that this song does not loop. Much appreciated. What's really beautiful to hear there is when we hear that piano hit and then the strings pop up right after. Now that could be an arrangement thing, or that might be a sidechain compressor. Hello there. Suss it, resolve it. Thank you. That was really beautiful. Yeah, a little bit of a loop at the end, maybe, or maybe we were just playing the first part again at the end. This next one is called Guardian
of the Pharmacies. Oh, this is cool. Oh, this is really cool. Does this one loop, chat? Oh, yeah. Oh, you play that thing. Oh, my goodness, the sweeps. That was awesome. Oh. Like a steel drum solo. All right, that's a loop. All right, this was super awesome. I really, really, really love this song. This one's called Infestation. Oh my gosh, you guys were so right. I can't believe it took me this long to get around to listen to this. This is so much fun. Thank you to everyone who voted for this in the community tab and everyone who commented with suggestions of this. This is really a lot of fun. Let's explore a musical concept called Four on the Floor. Everyone listen to that lowest kick drum. It's hitting on every quarter note because there's no break to it, and it hits 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. That's called Four on the Floor. All right, I think it's looped right here. All right, that was so much fun. I want to talk about that for a second. First of all, again, thank you to everyone
for commenting and then voting for this, because this is so much fun. This next one is called Blood Coagulant.
Oh!
It's like groups of 11. It actually might be a group of 8 with a group of 3, just in terms of how the phrasing is working out. So not a true 11-4, but I could be wrong. Depends on what the composer's intention was.
Oh my gosh! Okay, that's our loop. We're going to move on to the next one. The next one is called The Filthy Mind. Oh my gosh, you guys.
This is insane. Yeah, so groups of 5, but really the phrasing.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Oh my gosh, right, so that's our loop there. We're going to pause it there. Okay. All right, let's talk about odd time signatures. So a lot of times when we have odd time signatures like 5-4, 5-8, 7-4, 7-8, 5-16, whatever it be. So that's going to be your 5s, your 7s, your 11s, because typically your 9s would be compound meter. 6s, sometimes compound, yeah, compound meter. And then your 2s, your 3s, your 4s are going to be simple meter. So when we have odd time signatures, so like 5 and 7, typically, they're actually broken up into smaller divisions of the beat. And that's how we actually feel the meter. Because if you think about it, we have 5 beats in a row. We could go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Or we go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. And it's sort of like in 4-4, how you have strong and weak beats. There's going to be certain beats that get more emphasis than others. And typically, in 5-4, it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's that group of 3 and 2. You go listen to like Bane's theme by Hans Zimmer from the Christian Bale Batman movies. And I think that's 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. Cool. Let's keep it rocking and rolling with Return to Slime. Oh, listen to that double kick drum. Oh. Oh. I think we might have looped there. Oh my gosh, chat, this OST is the most ludicrous thing I've probably listened to in 2 years. Like, oh my gosh, this is wild. Okay, Antarctic reinforcement, because that's a thing. So something interesting to listen to is the use of stuttering on this soundtrack when you hear like the sound cut in and out. I believe they're using a plugin called Stutter Edit from Isotope. Could be wrong. But I'm hearing a couple things that remind me of that. Yeah, I agree, Squiddy. Sounds like Stutter Edit. I think we're looping right here. Are we looping? All right, so cool. I'm absolutely loving this OST. I know I'm not doing a lot of teaching here today because I'm just honestly really, really enjoying the music. When I find something productive to say, I'll say something productive. This next one is called Left Alone. Now we're back to 5-4. 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2-3, 1-2. Or 5-8. I mean, it depends on how the composer wrote it all out, but it's 5-something. Of those little harp things in there. Right there. We're going to pause it there. We're going to go on to the next one called Outcast of the Sulfur something. I'll let you know the full name of it in just one moment. It's Outcast of the Sulfurous Seas. Everyone knows it was the schooner Hesperus that sailed the sulfury seas. The amount of work that went into this OST is just... it's insane. So I think we're hearing what we heard on an earlier track now. Yeah, yo, huge respect, DM Dokuro, excuse me. Like, I mean, Russ. That. Oh my gosh. Okay, we're going to pause it here because we are looping. This next one is called Raw, Unfiltered Calamity. How I like both my kombucha and my calamity. Also, my chocolate. And my apple cider, when I come to think of it. And my apple cider vinegar. Oh yes, guitars. Oh yes, please. Oh, heck yeah. Suss it! Dissolve it! Man. This is so good. We'll be right back. All right, and that was our loop.
Oh my gosh, you guys, honestly, like, I know I'm not talking a lot about stuff going on. It's because I genuinely am just fanboying out over this music. It is so good. This is just so good. This next one is called The Silence Before the Storms. Sorry, just Silence Before the Storms. No the. This one does not loop. Copy that. Thank you, chat. Kind of reminds me of Minecraft a little bit from a melodic and harmonic standpoint. Just what, yeah, it does. Especially the way it's evolving here, too. So this next one is a 9-minute, 23-second song. So we're going to hang out and listen to the whole thing, even though it does loop. Apparently there's 3 songs in one, so we're going to let it play through the whole thing. It's called the Leviathan Trilogy. Or Leviathan, if you say it that way. I say Leviathan. Listen to the dynamics in that bass synth. Mm-hmm.
Okay, so StarRath123 in the chat says this is the second song and it's called Siren's War Cry. Or Siren's Battle Cry. Again, conflicting reports, but you get the idea. We can hear where it's in groups of five, but again, it's broken down into sort of meter pulse groups of three and two. Now, no longer five. Now, like groups of six. This has got to be the third song. This is called Forbidden Lullaby. Can I just say that the drums, guitar, and piano, and bass throughout this entire soundtrack has really been phenomenal, especially for one person to do. Even programming of some of them are MIDI. Really, really high quality work. So, something for us to think about. Here's a piece of interesting info. When you hear the drums, and it sounds like the bottom of the drums is missing, it sort of sounds like... Yeah, it sounds like you're only hearing half of the drums. That's called a high-pass filter, and what's going on is that you're filtering out, or all the low sounds of drums are not being allowed to play, and just the high parts of the drum sound are being allowed to hear. Well, that was a lot of fun. This next one is called Cosmic Disgust. Ah, makes sense. Thank you, chat.
Let the beat drop!
Okay, and I think we're looping there. So we're going to pause it. This next one is called Interstellar Stomper. If you're just joining the stream, we're not letting the songs play all the way through. Chat's helping me out. We're listening to each one halfway through, which is a full time through the loop. I've never heard this before, not once ever, and I'm reacting in real time. All thoughts are off the top of my head. This next one is called Interstellar Stomper, and sometimes I say the names of the songs correctly. almost reminds me of Doom. I tell you what. It also sounds like using Isotope Break Tweaker, maybe. Isotope, when are you gonna sponsor these streams, guys? You know I love you. Okay. We looped there. That was incredible. Those guitars really reminded me a lot of Doom in terms of those sort of microtonal expression bend things that were happening within those notes. Really cool. This next one is called A Play Pest of the Cosmos. Very interesting. I think this is the second song we've heard the kick drum essentially holding eighth notes. And this is why I'm saying that. I take that back. Before there was one. So I'm hearing this is groups of nine. And ten. What, 19? Maybe I'm counting wrong. I was getting so caught up trying to count the time signature there. This next one is called Fly of Beelzebub. As Freddie Mercury said, Beelzebub has a fly put aside for me. Let's keep it going. So really interesting, I'm hearing every once in a while a group of six thrown in there. Again, I could be wrong. I feel like I'm living in the Twilight Zone right now. I think this is the first vocals we've heard. So you're clearly five. All right, we're gonna pause it there. That's Loop. I'm getting so caught up with these time signatures. This is so much fun. This is so cool. I've been contending with like 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 8, and 4, 4 for so long. Heading into these 5 4s, I'm like, wait, what? This next is called Open Frenzy. Yeah, it is very Doom. Except it's a little melodic up top for Doom. And those arpeggiating synthesizers on the right. Thank you.
Now you gotta say loop, but I don't think we heard that screaming the first time around. Maybe we did and I missed it. Alright, we're gonna pause there. Okay, guys, let's talk real quick about compound meters. So a compound meter like 12/8, there's actually only four beats in the measure. The 12 is talking about the beat divisions. Those aren't actually the beats. So when we talk about actually measuring the BPM of that, we're not going to talk about what the eighth note is equal to. We're going to talk about what the dotted quarter is equal to. In this case, this piece was closer to 150 BPM. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, and then fine. One, two, three, duck it, 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 like that. Okay, let's keep it going. This next one is called Storms Before the Catastrophes. All right, this does not loop. Copy. Thank you, chat. So that instrument we heard right there sounds to me like an oboe. What we're hearing right now is a flute. Oh, something's happening. Unholy ambush. Listen to those chords. Those definitely sound like they're sidechain compression.
or they have a really slow attack. And the feeling of the suspense of them coming in late like that, the anticipation of them is phenomenal. Hearing right now the meow sound is a phaser. Usually could also be a envelope modulator. May have said that wrong. What's that thing called? Auto filter. Phaser. Oh, yes, Liz. I'm getting so caught up in these sounds. This next one is called Unholy Insurgency. I love that. Dubstep style bass there. Excellent. I think I'm starting to get a hang of this loop thing. This next one is called Feral Amalgamation. So when you hear, that very high instrument, almost sounds like someone whistling. You hear how the notes are not right next to each other, there's jumps between the notes. In this case, because it's going from low to high, it's an arpeggio. Well, it's also going from high to low as well. Arpeggios can go low to high and high to low. Oh, meter change here, feels like. I wasn't paying attention to the beginning, so I'm sure. Oh yeah, fretless bass now. Or it sounds like fretless bass. Oh, yes, please. Okay, so we'll pause here. Now, guys, something for you to watch out and to listen for is when we have these metal moments in these songs, listen for the guitar, oftentimes the bass, and the drums to all be on the same page with the rhythms that are being played. So you'll hear the drum, the low kick drum, along with the guitar, all together at the same time. This is something that is typical of the metal genre. Yes, a metal moment, Tang Corporations in chat. I said it. This next one is called Toxic Wisdom. That's a rhythm we've heard a couple times so far. I'll break it down next time it comes around, if it comes around again. Thank you.
Okay, so what we're going to look for is the yugga da gump, da-gump, or some version thereof. So you may remember from the Ace Attorney soundtracks, we had 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. Here we have 1-dump, yugga da gump, da-gump. It's the same idea. It's taking these repeated groups of, well, notes, rhythms, and, well, repeating them. I feel like I'm repeating myself now. 1-2-3-4, 1-2-3-4, yaga, yaga de gump, daga de gump, daga. And sometimes it's yaga de gump, yaga de gump, gump, or gump right on the beat. Let's go ahead and keep this going and keep our eyes out for those rhythms as we go. Servants of the Scourge.
Okay, this next one is called Scourge of the Universe. Wow, so much going on here. Secondary melody in your left ear. Oh, now panning over. Now it's in your right ear. So up top, we have that sort of Alberti style arpeggio. Wow, this soundtrack is taking me for a ride and wearing me out, folks. It's like a workout. Just listen to this thing. It's amazing. The amount of work and effort and energy that went into this. Mind-blowing. Sounds like the bass is fretless again, or made to sound fretless. I think I caught it. All right, Universal Collapse is up next, because what happens after the Scourge of the Universe comes to your universe? Well, Universal Collapse. Oh my gosh, so much going on. Again, doing like a secondary melody all the way on the right.
Passing it over this here.
All right, and that's the loop. Okay, let's go to Murder Swarm. Oh yeah, guitar. That was interesting. That was like 15. All right, that's our loop. Thank you, chat, for keeping me on. Sometimes I'm getting carried away looking at those time signatures and things. This next one is called Infernal Catharsis Rebirth. Man. So listen to the guitar and the kick drum together. And the guitar work here is really good. Okay, I think that's our loop. Okay, this next one is called Roar of the Jungle Dragon. Not to be confused with George of the Jungle Dragon. Beautiful. Yes, this is a hardship most dire, and one day you will hear what I say. This is my message to my master. This is a fight you can. Cool. Oh, yes. Awesome. Loved it. Loved it. Loved it. Shout out and thank you to Jacob King for your super chat. Also for being a member of this channel. Jacob says, my thanks for listening to this OST. Well, Jacob, thank you for suggesting this OST. Let's keep it rocking and rolling with The Step Below Hell, also known as The Place Where I Turn Around and Run Back the Other Way. Cool, looks like we're for some relaxing music here. Give my neck a break from all that headbanging. Now make sure you hang out till the end of the stream to hear my final reaction. Go ahead and pause that and move on to our next one, which is called Heaven's Hell Sent Gift. Very confusing. Seems like that one got lost in the mail somewhere. So we can hear pads swelling to the mid left. We have piano, two different pianos. We have that sort of like crashing piano chords, then we have the melodic piano right here. And then all the way on the right, we have sort of like these brush sound percussive things. To the heaven-sent abomination. Yeah, unknown artist. You can hear that those two pianos sound fundamentally different from each other. There's like one piano's here, one piano's here. And like, if you guys listen, you can hear the timbre. Timbre means the quality of the sound. You hear the difference in the timbre or the timbre between the two pianos. This piano over here is warm. It's round. This piano over here, it's harder. It's colder. It has more of an edge to it. Now it sounds like the arpeggio piano is coming more in the center. Maybe a little bit of a change in the mix. Or maybe I've just been hearing it over here because the melodic piano is over here. That was sick. Well, hang on, we're looping here. We're going to bring it to the treasures within the abomination. From the chat, the Religi says, do you think this is a good rework or a mem one? Well, I don't know. This is my first time ever hearing it, so I don't know if it's a good rework or not. This is my first time ever hearing this music. Here again, we have kick drum that is four on the floor. Kick, 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 kick. Thank you. There's our loop right there. All right, let's go into Wasteland, which is next. All those waves are so peaceful. Oh, I love those synths. Those chordal synths here. Oh, and they're also panel lumber over here as well. Oh, so rich, so deep. Love them. I think what's cool to talk about too with this OST is I'm not hearing a lot of really expensive patches being used. I think some of the instrument patches maybe, because some of them sound really realistic for audio units. But a lot of these sounds I recognize from Logic Pro and things like that. Like, and I think it's really a testament to Dokuro's creativity and ear and artistry that to use these sound palettes to really create something incredible. That's giving me some Pink Floyd vibes. That was our loop right there. This next one is called Sanctuary. That sounded like a phaser on that cymbal. That was really cool. Thank you. Okay, we're looping there. This next one is called hadoplegic pressure. I'm not sure what hadoplegic means. Hey, chat, what does hadoplegic mean? No, I didn't. Not saying the right. Hadoplegic. So it's like down in the ocean trenches. Huh. Thank you, chat. The Haddle Zone, also known as the Hadoplegic Zone, is the deepest region of the ocean lying within oceanic trenches. The Haddle Zone, or Haddle Zone, is found from the depth of around 6,000 to 11,000 meters. That can be 18,000. That's pretty deep. Now, that arpeggio right there is the same arpeggio you hear when you are in Zelda, I think in the fairy caves, maybe? Link to the Past? Okay, and here's our loop. So we're going to go ahead and move on to Void. Okay, so pay attention here to everything that's going on in the background, because there's a lot going on. There's like a drone over here, drone pad over here. There's another pad over here. There might be a third pad that's spread out very wide, large stereo image. Oh, that harp with that reverb on there does sound very bubbly. Very aquatic. Thank you. And if you hear anything other than whales singing when you're in the actual ocean, run. Skip to the next one called Threats of the Ocean Floor. That was our loop. We're going to move forward. This one was called Catastrophes Before the Calamity. Oh, that's cool. Thank you. Oh, I love that piano. Reminds me of Steve Vai. So here we hear that riff again. Yeah, 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 this is called Stained, Brutal Calamity. Oh, goodness. We'll be right back. Man, that dude can sing. Oh yeah, that bass. Oh,
Wow.
I feel like we just won something.
Hey, member Nicholas. Wow, so this was an incredible OST. Now, we do have a couple extra minutes here, so we're going to listen to one extra song. Now, I do want to address a couple questions. I've been having some issues typing in. I think I'm having a browser issue. Every time I try and type, my browser stops letting me type, so I'm not sure what's going on. So I'm just going to respond here to submit suggestions for the OSTs to listen to. Put them in the comments. You can also put them here in the stream. Put them in the comments because I read the comments. Now we're gonna listen to one more. Thank you all so much for joining me. I'm gonna give you my final reaction and listen to one more track as a bonus. I absolutely loved this soundtrack. It was absolutely incredible. For the guitar work, the bass, the drums, the synths, everything coming together, so creative. And on such a high level, I understand why creating this would have taken a long time, because honestly, if I had to try and create something like this, it would take me a very, very long time too. A very, very high level. All right, folks, what do you think? Blessing of the Moon, Guardian of the Form, something, Open Frenzy, 16-bit, Arctic Reinforcement, Siren's Call, or Scourge of the Universe? What are y'all thinking? Put it in the chat. Let's see what we got. We'll do this live. We'll do it live! Okay. Let's see. I don't think I have Tyrant. Cold Front, best ones. Arctic. All right, I saw Arctic. I saw Scourge. All right, we're going to do Scourge. I saw a bunch of Scourges. Here we go. Last track. This is great piano work. Just a reminder to everyone, please hit like, please hit subscribe, hit that notification bell. Links to some awesome number one best-selling music books in the description, as well as 50% off music lessons. Well, that was a really chill and nice way to end the stream. Thanks for recommending, chat. All right, you guys. I will see y'all next time. Please hit like, subscribe, hit that notification bell. Remember, you can support this channel by becoming a member. You can also, let's see, in the description below, you can check out 50% off music lessons. Also, links to our number one best-selling music books. Thank you to Jacob King for the super chat today. Thank you to everyone for joining on the stream. Thank you for watching if you're watching on demand. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for recommending that I listen to this. This was a ton of fun. See you guys.